It's been 7 years since the largest African-American museum on the East Coast opened its doors. The Reginald F. Lewis Museum of Maryland African-American History and Culture is renowned for showcasing Maryland's rich history and culture. Joining us today is the executive director, Dr. Skip Sanders. We want to welcome him. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you for having us.
Absolutely. It's a pleasure having you. Now, you invite visitors to take the journey. Tell us about that journey and what they're going to experience.
Well, the journey really is a metaphor word, and it's a metaphor for learning. So if they come and take that journey, they may be learning things they never knew before about African American history and culture, particularly in Maryland. They may be relearning some things and finding out that they didn't have all the information that's now there to be shared, and things that change your sort of your perspective a little bit. They'll be learning, other than history, some experiential things like some of the fantastic food of the culture, or experiencing lectures, movies, activities for children, lots of showcase things, for instance, when we do musical presentations or have cocktail hours. So there are all kinds of things to experience there.
Even as long as you've been there, have you still learned? Are you still learning from each exhibit?
Every day. As a matter of fact, my fear is I'll show my ignorance at the wrong time. There is so much. I've yet, frankly, in almost a year, I still haven't mined the entire depth of all the exhibits there, especially in the permanent exhibit. There's so much there, it's just unbelievable.
So what's the highlight for you? Is there one?
Yes, but it might surprise you. We have three themes, and one of the themes is called the strength of the mind. In that particular area, there are a couple of things I really love. One of them is a replica of a one-room schoolhouse, and it's because of the teaching background. A cute story is some children were there one day, and I could tell that they weren't understanding that this was, in effect, an entire school. They were seeing it as, this is what one classroom would look like. Mm. And so when I got them to understand, no, this was the whole school for as long as you were in school, and, you know, mixed grades and everything in this little small cramped area, their eyes got big. And then this one little boy says to me, "What's that?" And he pointed to the chalkboard, and I said, "That's a chalkboard." He said, "What's a chalkboard?" And I went, "Oh my God, I'm an artifact."
It's true.
They don't have that anymore.
Right.
So then I explained that, and I said, "Well, the teacher uses chalk." He says, "What's chalk?" And I said, "I think I don't want to pursue this."
Don't you remember the erasers and how you had to clean them at the end of the day?
And I hated it because I got dust all over me, but he didn't have any of that
Amazing.
Great experience.
Yeah, and it wasn't even that long ago, those chalkboards. Now, the history of African Americans, it's so deeply rooted in the history of our state.
Yes.
Why is it so important to continue to teach all of us about that?
I heard a great saying yesterday, and I hope I don't maul it, but it went, if you know your past, you can control your future. If you know your present, you can control your past. Mm-hmm. So I think that's a very true statement. When we look at African American history in the whole country, really, it's all interwoven. It's one history. African Americans were part of what was going on in our country from the very beginning. And as you begin to understand that, and as we understand one another, we begin to understand why we truly are one American family. Mm-hmm. And ultimately, as you know, we're one human family because we're 99% genetically alike.
Yeah.
So we want to use this story to really help build that sense of being one American family through all of our different experiences and through sharing our iconic experience with people of all other cultures who, in many cases, shared similar experiences of being challenged as they became Americans. That's mm-hmm. true of Irish people, Italians, Germans, Filipinos, Chinese, Japanese, Mexican Americans. So it covers Native Americans have experienced mm-hmm. it. So there is so much that we can share by sharing our stories.
Yeah, and we're not so far removed from the experiences that people are learning about when they come to the museum.
Exactly.
What strikes you most about young people when they react to what they're seeing and learning?
What I really have noticed, and it's actually heartwarming, is that you can actually see a deeper sense of pride, of self-understanding and self-esteem coming from that. As a matter of fact, we have some young student interns who work for us at times, and I can see backs straightening, eyes glowing, the beauty of the building itself, but then the strength and the beauty of the stories mm-hmm. of unsung as well as sung heroes. has to have an impact on you and how you feel about yourself. Then you can begin to talk about the dignity you should have, the respect for citizens and other people and for your place of living that you should have.
Without a doubt. What are some of the advantages of joining the Legends and Legacies experience?
Oh, it's a great advantage. First of all, we see ourselves as three sister institutions, and it's a great opportunity for us to really share and promote one another. So it's really strengthened our relationship. And what we get a chance to offer people is, I call, the whole story. So you're not just getting a third of it because you're coming to the place you heard about and knew about. You're really getting the opportunity to experience the whole of the story mm-hmm. by this combined experience. And we love the fact that we're able to share and promote and serve and help one another.
Well, we hope you get a lot of visitors this summer.
So
there will
we.
Be lots of opportunities for that. Such a pleasure meeting you. I'm glad
My
we
pleasure.
Finally got to meet in person.
Thank you
Thanks
so much.
Thanks a lot for being here.